The Starlink service offers a unique new connectivity profile with a great amount of bandwidth coupled with revolutionary low latency for a satellite system. Still, when using even such a service for supplying connectivity to a remote business or crew, it is important to ensure that you are not wasting any of the available bandwidth so as to improve performance, service availability, and user experience. It is also very important to be able to secure your remote sites, ensuring the safety and confidentiality of your sensitive network traffic, and maintaining a good cybersecurity posture in today's harsh online environments. My name is Anastasis Kriponsiotis, and I'm a Director of Software Engineering here at Speedcast, leading the Sigma development team. Today's remote environments are much more challenging to secure. We see increasing numbers of connected devices while at the same time having more available bandwidth to consume. The default Starlink Maritime offering does not come bundled with any way to isolate local networks and very limited tools to control incoming and outgoing traffic. This is another area where our Sigma product family complements Starlink services. Sigma offers a rich toolset of network management and security tools that are centrally managed. The Sigma products are also carrier agnostic, which means that our customers can manage all their connectivity solutions in a single platform, simplifying operations and security. So let's have a look at how Sigma can help us achieve all this. So let's start by going over the lab setup we'll be using. We have a Sigma gateway today, and we have connected to it the two Starlink antennas that comprise the Starlink Maritime offering, as well as a VSAT modem carrying a voice and two data VLANs over a trunk port. For LANs, we have set up an Ops LAN, a crew LAN that offers DHCP. Sigma firewall rules being WAN aware means that you can create very granular security rules based on the connectivity profile you are using each time. This means that you can create firewall rules for very critical traffic that is allowed over any available WAN at any moment, while other traffic that is not considered critical could have limited rules and only be allowed over Starlink or another high bandwidth solution. As we can see, I have a firewall rule here that allows pinging from the crew, and I am allowing it over any WAN, which is exactly why it has been working so far. I can edit this rule and only allow through Starlink port, saving the rule and allowing it to propagate. If I try to ping from the crew VM now, I will not be able to. Apart from being WAN aware, the Sigma firewall also allows you to flexibly create your own firewall service definitions. The construct of a firewall service allows us to create objects that can later flexibly be used on one or more firewall rules. Apart from setting this definition, you can also set up the login level, which will affect how much detail is returned in the traffic reporting modules of the portal, whether you want this traffic to be NATed or not, and also setting up a QoS flag for the traffic belonging to this service. For QoS, it can allow prioritizing time-sensitive or operationally critical flows over non-essential traffic. Firewall rules can be configured as either postpaid or prepaid. Postpaid firewall rules allow traffic through the Sigma firewall without any additional user action. They are suitable for non-interactive data flows, such as servers consuming internet resources, or traffic that does not need to be controlled by usage quotas. A prepaid rule, on the other hand, allows traffic through the Sigma firewall only after a user has successfully authenticated and only from the device used to authenticate the user session. They are suitable for user-generated interactive sessions that may need to be under daily, weekly, or monthly quota. Fair use policies can also be applied to protect from excessive bandwidth use. The prepaid capabilities of Sigma also allow crew services to be monetized. Having seen all the standard features of the Sigma product family that allow us to manage our firewall, our path selection, and our remote networks, we come to our cybersecurity as a service offering. Cybersecurity as a service is a Speedcast managed cybersecurity solution that is completely transparent to deploy. It does not require any additional network design changes on the remote site. Cybersecurity as a service complements the standard security features of the Sigma product family by adding application layer filtering, as well as IPS and IDS capabilities, along with antivirus. Now we can go and deploy a policy. We will be denied the traffic. These policies can be templated and used for multiple sites at the same time, and they can also be audited to ensure cybersecurity compliance.